Start.
Hi, it's Lil from Teamwork again. Quite a few people have been asking me to do a tutorial about making face masks, because I've been making them for the family and to various people if they want to make a donation to Teamwork. So that's what I'm going to do today. Before I start, I'd just like to say that a big thank you to Aldi, who have donated these fabrics to Teamwork. They're lovely fat quarter quilting cottons. That's a funny name, I know, a fat quarter, and maybe I'll explain about that another time. But anyway, they're really nice quality cottons and ideal for making one of these masks. I'm also using as the lining some white cotton that I have in the house. If you don't have anything like that, you could make it from an old pillowcase or a bit of sheeting, you know. Good if you can use 100% cotton, but I know that that's not always possible these days. Right then, so you need one large rectangle, 24 centimetres by 19. I've got a paper template here, and I've cut out a nice piece of pattern fabric. And then for the lining, you need two pieces of white cotton or a plain cotton, 18 centimetres by 13 centimetres. You need two of those. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to go to my iron and iron both of the long edges on the lining pieces. So I'm just going to fold it over about a quarter of an inch, use steam iron, then I'm going to fold it over again, and that saves you having to do anything like tacking. Now I'm going to stitch those on the sewing machine. Just a little word about the size of the needle you might like to use. I'm using an 80 on this cotton, which is a kind of medium size. You might need a 90, just depends, because you've got quite a few pleats to sew through at the end. I'm also going to use different colour thread so that you can see the stitching on the white. Okay, so this is the lining, one of the lining pieces. Don't need to even finish off the edges, because that will be sewn in at another part. I've already done this one, so I've got two pieces now, and I've got my main fabric. I'm going to go back to the... No, in fact, I can do it here. So I'm going to put my right sides together. I'm going to centre this like that. And this piece down here, leaving a little gap. These are smaller than the main part of the fabric. I'm just going to pin them in place, a couple of pins. This forms the lining, and like a little pocket where you can put a tissue inside your mask, which gives you a little bit more protection. Okay, right, so I'm going to sew those now on the machine. Usual sort of 5/8 seam allowance. One side. remember and put your pins in the way I've put them in here, and then you can just stitch right over them. Saves you having to tack. That's that done. Take the pins out. And I'm going to go and iron this now to the right side. I'm going to trim off these pieces of thread so that they don't get tangled up. Right. Always have your iron on when you're sewing. Really helps to get a nice finish. Okay, so now I'm going to fold these in. Press that down because that will help later on. And I'm going to press this side down now. There we go. Okay, now then, this is the tricky part. When you are doing your pleats. So you've got to pleat, put about three pleats in, quite small, but you've also got to pleat the lining at the same time. So I'm going to put that up like that. And I'm going to put a pin in the middle to secure it. I'm not going to press it yet. Next pleat. I'm just going to do this by eye. You'll get the hang of it. And actually, it doesn't have to be perfect because you won't see it because the mask opens up. And that's another one. There. Check that's okay at the back. That's fine. I'm going to give this a little press to keep them in place. And then I'm going to stitch down the sides. Quite near to where the lining, about 1/4 inch in from the edge of the lining. Same on the other side, but I'm going to make my stitch slightly bigger, I think, for this. Okay. Now I can take my pins out. The basis of your mask. Now we want to finish off this bit, so this is a little bit tricky. You've got to you want a nice neat edge. I'm going to cut off all the little bits of thread so they don't get caught up there. And the first thing I'm going to do is to turn this in slightly. not all the way in, it's just that you want to have a nice neat edge. Folding over all those little pleats that you've made. That's it. And then I'm going to fold it right over onto the inside of the mask. Give it another press. Same with this side. Little narrow turning over. And then all the way over. You can put a pin in this if you like, but in the middle, it's quite thick, so I think I'm just going to take the, so can you see that? I've folded this edge in first, and then I've folded it over again, covering up all the raw edges. This gives you a nice finish on your mask. Definitely use a bigger stitch now, because you're sewing through all of those thicknesses. I'm going to put the needle in first. Sometimes that little corner wants to come out. There we go, it's one side done. The other side. Don't worry too much about it being straight. It's that isn't really the exercise, is it? We want to just make nice masks forever. Right, so that really is the mask completed, apart from a bit of tidying up. The only thing I've got to do now is to put in some elastic. I tend to not tie these. I tend to let people alter the elastic to suit themselves. And I've got this a bodkin that you usually use to sew up knitted items. So I'm going to use that to thread that little channel that you've made. Sometimes you have to fiddle about. Oh no, that's coming, that's easy this time. Okay, so that's that one. And I'm going to tie it. I'm just going to, you know, sometimes I make it a bit, I think this is about 12 inches of elastic that I've put in here. You could use flat elastic too, but try not to make it too thick. I mean, like 5 millimeters at the most width. And then I'm going to tie it here. If you're using the flat elastic, it might be better to stitch it. And then you can lose that knot if you fiddle about. You can push that down in there. It'll come through eventually. That's it. So then you haven't got that ugly knot up. Oh, it's come right through the other side now. That's it. Okay, so that's one side done. Do the second one. I mean, I know these aren't medical masks and they're not going to stop you getting the virus, but they do help offer a little bit of protection Now this one's a bit fiddly. I've got to sometimes go in from the other side if you can't get it to go through one way. Yeah, that's it. Depends which way your pleats are folded. If you've got a small safety pin, that would also work in threading your elastic, because you'll never be able to thread it through just by trying to feed it through yourself. It would be too difficult. Sometimes I do a couple of knots. Okay, right, I'm going to trim up these threads. It and then I'll just show you how to put the here's my tissue. I'm going to pop that inside in between in the lining and pop that in. There's been all sorts of things that people are putting in inside their face masks for added protection, but I think this is adequate. And then pop it behind your ears. Pull it under your chin and over your nose. The end.